George Ngeri Omesa. My artistic name is Onkoba. I'm an artist, a visual artist, but I'm also a poet, a designer. I do design things and also a framer at the moment, but I don't know what will come tomorrow, maybe something else. But whatever I know is forever I'll be an artist. So I've been doing it for a long time. It used to be like a joke, for fun, hobby, but eventually now it is my career. What pays my bill, it is what pays for my children's school fees, everything. To me, at the moment, it is about art, creativity. And it is, okay, you can say it has been a challenging road, but to me, I think I find joy in conquering the challenges, because I was a banker, but then I had to leave and become a full-time artist. How I left is a story for another day. But now I enjoy what I'm doing. Then I used to enjoy counting people's money, because now I'm turning out what is on my mind, what is in my soul. That's what I put on canvas or paper or whatever I put. I'm able to share my soul, which I could not do when I was a banker. Briefly, that's what I can say is my story. A year ago, I used to do my work at the Calvert down on the road, that is Loratio Ridge. It was the garage where the garage is. I had a friend of mine who had given me a space in his workshop where I used to work with, but it never gave me that freedom. So I used to enjoy it working in a culvert or at the roadside. So when the year ended, my friend told me, indicated to me that he couldn't accommodate me this year. So out of that frustration, that's how I found this place. I had no money, I had nothing. But I always believe it is God who gave me this place, and I'm able to pay it, and I'm able to work. That's how I transitioned to this place. Now I'm calling it the Art Kiosk, where I'm able to do my art, my designing, and also do framing for myself and other people who are interested. Yeah. I do design. I have some paintings.
I
make frames. Plastic. Both the rustic and the, how do I call them, the conventional one, the conventional one. Also, hold up. So most of my work, like this one, it is more of poetic. Yeah, my work is more poetic. So most of my works in canvas are rolled up, because of the environment I am in. This one, I did it in the year 2007, it was about politics. And I used the slogans for a former president, Uzanguni. This is Mukai Voivo. I think people know who are the authors of those words. So I will say, in whichever the way, to me, this one appeared to be like a prophecy. Because when you see here, this is like a mixture of fruits. Eventually, whatever happened after 2007, we ended up having government of national unity. Yeah, in my mind it never occurred, and that's why I've held this piece precious to me. Yeah. Okay, when it comes to designing and making frame, I do with recycled material. Any frame that I make, it is, I call them ni kuokoa kuni, because ingechomwa ikuwe vumbi, but for me, I kind of resurrect it, save it, from the fire and make something beautiful out of it. Like this one. Just to be fine.
That again?
This is my daughter's aunt.
And how old is she?
She's now 5 years and 5 months. Mm-hmm. And this is my son's aunt. He is three and a half years. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So these are my poem. When they ask, I am mad. Yes, I'm mad. I make a difference. You take it. Am I mad at you? No. Because the average people don't get mad. I'm not a below average person. Yes, I'm mad for I do love. Yes, I'm mad for I do speak out. Yes, I'm mad since I shout out my heart. I do things differently. I mean, in a mad way, yes. For I am a thinker. Mad, yes. This this artwork was inspired by a picture twin where a child was thrown by the mother after being given birth, and we had literally to destroy to save that life. I've never known how the child fared on, but I believe the child survived. But I don't know how. So that pain of being a parent and seeing another child being thrown in a picture twin is the one who made me to draw this. Petra Twin, it was in our neighborhood where we used to stay that period. That you can see when it has some pieces, it is a full set, bedroom set. This is supposed to be a wardrobe, but I've never finished it because kenda kukachine get new ideas start from them. So it might look as hell, but in my mind I know how it should end. One day when I get the site, I'll finish it. My vault. I call it a vault because that's where my stories are kept. Yeah. That's where my stories are kept. I like the
answers there. Did you go to school for art?
Okay, I went to school, that is up to form 2. That's when I learned art. Then something occurred into my mind. My mother used to weave. She never went to school. She used to do agriculture. She never went to school. And they fed our generation up to this time. I'm not saying those people go to school to study art are doing it wrongly. But it's like it occurred to me it was a talent. And I had to go and learn different things. So I went and did study accounting. So from the university or college, I'm an accountant. Yeah. But my level for art education formally is up to form 2. But these other styles, I get to learn them from either Googling or going through workshop. Like the style I'm doing, it was a workshop that I went, I paid, then got to know it. But eventually, you being an artist, you have to expand. You go beyond the boundaries. And I think I always try to push myself beyond the boundaries. That's why, okay, initially my first work, you see, it has influence of the person who taught me. But now, I'm breaking from that influence. Yeah. I believe in God. God is real. So all my diaries, the first page I dedicated to God, and this is my signature. Mm. It did a fraud, and then, okay, me as a supervisor, I was the one who authorized the payment. But he took his money, but eventually came back and said he never withdrew the money. But the reality, he and I think her girlfriend, who was a bank official, connived to steal from us. Yeah. So that's how I used to document it. Document my work. He's still the one. Yeah. But this one who I am. Okay. This one, I was depressed during my transition from banking now into outside life. I call it outside life. I joined briefly, I did insurance, but I never found it to be my thing. So that's why you see the tree is black, but the outside is blue. That was reflected wherever I was going to. Yeah. But it is on top of a painting that I did. Like, to me, was my journey. It is a journey. Behind it is a journey, the life's journey. The challenges we get wherever. So I decided to cover it. I had no material, nothing. But it helped me to come out of that depression.
This is my character. I call it Chausiku. Chausiku, yeah. She's called Chausiku. She has a name. Yeah. Why Chausiku?
Chausiku.
How did Chausiku come up?
Chausiku came about in 2009. And it was initially about people used to talk without doing things. That's why you see she has a lips which are bigger for yapping. But eventually Chausiku has transitioned to be the peri-urban girl of Nairobi. She, to me, she's able to tell the stories I see about the Nairobi women. Yeah. That's how she transitioned.
Good, Bana, you are so my inspiration. Mm-hmm.
So
this was your diary that you used to...
Yes, but you kiangalia mbele, you see, unasabia tola pesa, but at the same time you're drawing. In fact, most of them know. This is what happened where I used to stay. Mtoto ya wisho paicho. We had to literally break it. This is when we voted. That this was in 2013. And so many things crazy that I used to do in office.
During your banking meetings, you write on your diary, you use your diary?
Yes.
As your sketch pad?
Yes. Okay, I used to be given a diary, but I used to go and buy a sketch pad. Use it as my diary. Because you can see here, this is a... The minutes, but you can see I've done it in my own way. I know what we used to talk about here. So these are the ones.
To me, I'm okay with it at the moment, but I make so ingino and seven daka serious card. But for me, I wanted something unique.
So one side you have my Safaricom number, and the other side you have my Orange number that I've kept for years. This is my Safaricom. This one stands for social media, Onkoba. Yeah, and this is the other one.